very soon. What if I say, I know, you know, what if I told you I like you, we stay, we go. Hello, and welcome to another episode of What Keeps Me Up at Night. Tonight, it is neither what people think about feminism, no period pains that is keeping me awake. Tonight, what is keeping me awake is the amount of power Nigerian women have placed in the hands of the males in their lives. And I'm talking about their brothers, their husbands. I went to make my hair today and I had a long conversation with the woman who makes my hair, and she was saying that she cannot make this beautiful hair color because her husband might beat her up and send her packing. And I told her I couldn't relate because I am a woman in my own rights, and I decide what I want to do on my head and in my body. And she was like, no, as a woman, you have to obey your husband though, because what your husband says is law. If you are single now, you can do anything, but immediately you're married, immediately put something for your head, you don't feel do anything. And that struck me. That means that if we abolish bride price, Nigerian men will not have the authority to tell women what to do now just because they put something for their head. Bride price is useless because it only makes the man feel that he is in total and complete control of the woman. He can do it as he please, discard her whenever he feels tired or he thinks she has sinned against him. I'm really sorry for many Nigerian women out there that are in the same boat with my hairdresser. I am really sorry that you are going through this. I hope that one day you'll find the strength to decide for yourself that you're going to be the sole proprietor of your choices. You're going to be the one who is completely in control of your life. I wish that for you, my dear woman. I really wish that for you, because you see this freedom I have? I can't give it up for anybody, anything. My freedom can never be exchanged for anything. So, Nigerian woman, I'm speaking to you today. Many of you women, your husbands will not let you work. Your husbands will not let you wear certain clothes. Your husbands will not let you go to the market. How come your husband can do everything that he can do and you can't do everything that you can't do? Anyway, I honestly hope that very soon we are going to have gatherings of women who are willing to unlearn this bullshit behavior of dependency on man, of needing the validation of man, of a male in your life to survive. I hope that someday in the future that mentality is going to change and we are going to be great again. Because I believe that the script was flipped. I do not believe that a woman came from a man's ribs. I believe a woman pushed out a man from her womb. Anyway, I will leave you here today. Hopefully we'll see you in another brand new episode of What Would People Say. Until then, tell me what you think. Have your say.